Hello! Thank you, DJ. Hello, Nigeria. Hello, let me feel the love. Hello. Thank you, thank you. I was so nervous backstage, I almost left, but I hear there's a slogan in Nigeria now, no leave. So are they here? How do they go? My name is OB Amponsah. I'm a stand-up comedian and I'm an optometrist and an eye doctor in Ghana. There's this thing I've realized with people, anytime you introduce yourself to people as a doctor, that is when they find their problems. Have you realized it? Yes, anytime I tell somebody, hi, my name is OB, I'm an eye doctor, especially ladies, they're like, oh my God, really? Really? My eyes have been itching. So I've changed my profession. Anytime I meet a lady, I'm like, hey, my name is OB, I'm a gynecologist. No problem. No gynecological problem. Let's move on. It's crazy. I chose to be a comedian because I want to be honest in my life. There are some careers you choose, you'll never be honest for the rest of your life. Like being a footballer. African footballers are the reason we have something we call football age. There's a goalkeeper in Nigeria. His name is Francis Uzoho. Ladies and gentlemen, Francis Uzoho is 19 years old. And he has a 17-year-old son. This Francis Uzoho was producing sperms at the age of 2. There's another Nigerian player called Taiwo. He was celebrating his 25th birthday while his other brother was celebrating his 37th birthday. And guess what? They are twins. There's a footballer in Ghana. We call him Don Bote. When I was young, at 10 years old, I write his name at the back of my jersey because he was a professional footballer. Now I'm 29, Don Bote is 24. What the fuck was he born in a leap year? I don't get it. Footballers can lie. I was watching this under 17 tournament. It was between Ghana and Brazil. And for those of you who don't know football, let me teach you. Under 17, you have to be 16 years and below before you qualify to play. Brazil scored Ghana. We equalized. And then finally, our captain had the final goal, Steven Appiah. In his moment of ecstasy, he forgot about himself and took off his shirt. The hairs on his chest, 27 years. And he was all over the stadium. And we realized the coach was following him. We thought they were jubilating together, not knowing he was warning him. Hey, idiot, wear your shirt. They are watching, wear your shirt. And afterwards, they decided to interview this guy. There's this thing I don't get with footballers, especially African footballers. Why is it that when they are being interviewed, they don't speak their local dialect? Why? Because Ronaldo, if Ronaldo after a match, they go to him, Ronaldo, how did you see the game? He's like, Espinoza, Caponazio, football. And then somebody will tell me, oh, he says the first half was good, the second half was good, football. Matter what people, you can't speak the English well, they still want to speak. And they're always nervous. So after Steven has been scored the final goal and all that, they approach him. They're like, Steven, how are you?
I'm fine.
How did you see the game?
I didn't see it. I was playing some.
Okay, Steven, we see you're a very young guy, you know, we see you are very active. How do you keep active?
Every morning when I wake up, I run away. And the next morning, I ran away again.
Is it jogging?
Yes. That's why you call it jogging. I'll go for
it. Serious? And then this guy is 16. They said, anything you want to say to your family? He said,
yeah. I want to say hi
to my three daughters. Both of them are girls. I'm like, dude. So I thought the interviewer would shut up. He continued. He asked him, how about your parents? Anything you want to say to your parents? We're like,
you asked me a very sad question. Because my mother is no more. But my father is more.
That was when I put off my television. Your father is more. And then another group of people who actually lie about their age are ladies. Guys, have you ever asked a lady her age? They say it's rude. It's rude to ask a lady her age. It's rude. Sometimes when you are lucky, they say, guess my age. Now I'm here to advise all guys. Anytime a lady says, guess my age, the number that comes in your head is the right one. But don't be an idiot and mention it. Subtract 10 or 15 from that number before you tell her, hello. Guys, am I speaking to guys here? So when she says, oh my God, guess my age, the number that counts is like 42. Give her 29 and watch her reaction. Like, okay, baby, I'll give you 29. Like, really? Oh my God, really? Stop her. Some of you are so, some of you don't have patience. How old are you? 47. You're more than 47. And ladies, I'm here to talk to ladies. Ladies, are you here? Let me hear some woo from the ladies. Yes, we love you guys. You, every lady I've seen in this country is beautiful. What? Beautiful ladies. Though I haven't gotten a number yet, but beautiful. And you guys, man, see, Ghanaian ladies, African ladies, Nigerian ladies, everybody, please, we know you are beautiful, so take your time on the makeup. Now we cannot play girls' games with you. You know, earlier you could sneak up on a lady and cover her face, right? And say, girls, girls, girls. You dare not try that. Takes them 1 hour to apply foundation. And you, out of nowhere, say, hey, take off that, your stupid hand. Take off your stupid hand. Your stupid hand is full of paint. Like, baby, I'm sorry, baby. It's crazy. It's crazy. And there's this thing you guys do now. You know, God gave us eyebrows to give us expressions. Hello, I'm talking to you as an optometrist from Ghana. Eyebrows give us expressions. So when you're angry, when you're happy, it opens up. And some of you have decided to shave off your eyebrows. And your drawing sucks so much, you draw something there. You meet a lady throughout the day, she has one expression throughout the day. You meet a lady, this is her face. I don't know how are you, Avan. Are you sad? No. Are you shocked? No. Are you surprised? No. Why this? I'm embarrassed. Ladies! I don't have my time. I don't have my time. Let me finish. And there's this thing now, ladies, you wear. I don't know how you call it. In Ghana, we call it bulletproof vest. How do you call it here? What's it? Waist trainers, right? Oh my goodness, why do you guys worry yourself that much? You meet a lady, she cannot breathe. Like, baby, are you okay? Are you asthmatic? Why do you guys suffer like that? See, no guy in the history of Nigerian men, no guy will take a lady to the room, she takes off her dress, and the guy looks at her stomach and like, come on. Like, I go, no. But your stomach, no guy. He will roll it back. And chuck it with his elbow. Finish off. I said, baby, go on and be a politician. Go on, baby. You don't have time. And it gives you guys some high-pitched soprano voice. You meet a lady, I met one lady, I was like, hey, how are you? She's like, oh, fuck! I'm like, why? Is that your voice? Like, yes! So, wow, what's your name? My name is Anita! I'm like, wow. I took Anita home. Anita took off her waist trainers. I was like, baby, should I get you something from there?
Yeah, give me some juice. the university. What happens when I take off my real training? My real voice comes in.
How does your voice change from Celine Dion to Don Jazzy? In 2 seconds. My name is OB Amponsah, ladies and gentlemen. I love you, Nigeria.